गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी परफॉर्म वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एक्सपेरिमेंट दैट इज स्टडी ऑफ इंपल्स जनरेटर। दिस इज इंपल्स जनरेटर, इट इज यूज्ड टू जनरेट स्टैंडर्ड लाइटनिंग ओवर वोल्टेज। एज पर इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड द स्टैंडर्ड लाइटनिंग इंपल्स वोल्टेज इज 1.2/50 microseconds। 1.2 microseconds इज द राइज टाइम, ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज फ्रंट टाइम। That is the time required by the voltage wave to reach to the peak value, and T2, that is 50 microseconds, is the tail time, also called as decay time. It is the time required by the voltage wave to reduce to 50% of the peak value. The rating of this impulse generator is 150 kV, 225 joules, and 5 stages. It means each stage is rated for 30 kV. 30 into 5, that is 150 kV. This impulse generator operates on the principle of modified Mach circuit. First, I will discuss the different components of impulse generator. The first component is rectifier. So this rectifier or DC charging unit consists of this high voltage transformer rated up to 30 kV and this diode. So this is first component, that is DC charging unit. Second component is charging resistor. For each stage, there are 5 stages. So for each stage, we require charging resistor. So this constitute first stage charging resistor, second, third, fourth, and fifth. So these are charging resistors. Next component is charging capacitors. These boxes are nothing but high voltage capacitors. For one stage, 2 capacitors are there. They are connected in series. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. These are 5 sets of capacitors. That is C1. So spark gap is created by using these small spheres. They are movable so that we can change the distance between the spheres. So one stage, 2, 3, 4, and 5. This is first stage, this is last stage. Next component is wave shaping network. Now this wave shaping network consists of resistors R1 and R2. In case of modified Mach circuit, these resistors are connected internally. So this constitute R1, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Next is R2. So these are 5 resistors, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. The charging resistor, wave shaping network resistors R1, R2, they are wire wound high voltage resistors. Next component is the load capacitor, that also becomes the part of the circuit that is denoted by C2. So this is load capacitor, C2. Now in this impulse generator, R1, R2, C1 and C2, they are adjusted in such a way that output voltage waveform is of duration 1.2/50 microsecond wave. T1 and T2, they are functions of R1, R2, C1 and C2. So adjustment is according to Indian standards so that output voltage waveform is of duration 1.2/50 microseconds. Next unit is triggering arrangement. So this triggering arrangement is provided by means of this trigotron sphere gap. This is the first stage sphere gap. You can see here, inside this sphere there is one rod gap type, rod type electrode, this one. Now this rod gap type, rod type electrode is provided with a pulse of either polarity, positive or negative, by means of this capacitor resistor through the control panel. So this generates the trigger in the first spark gap,
and then all these power gaps are triggered sequentially so that all the capacitors are discharged in series generating standard tightening loops. Next is measuring unit. This is resistance potential divider having ratio of 1000:1. This is R1. R2 is inside this box. Now, in order to avoid the reflection of the voltage wave, we require one more resistor that is called as impedance matching resistor, and that is also inside this. And the voltage sample is taken through this cable, and outside this cage, we are having a digital storage oscilloscope to record the impulse voltage. So this constitute impulse voltage measuring circuit, resistance potential divider, impedance matching resistance, cable, and digital storage oscilloscope. This is the control panel of impulse generator. This shows the charging voltage. This is output voltage per stage. This shows charging current. This is dimmer stat to increase the voltage. Mains on, mains off. Then I shown you the spark gap. So these are the push buttons or press buttons for changing the distance. Now this is ground open and ground close switch. Normally the ground rod is there, which is closed. So before charging, we have to open this ground rod. Then this is HT on, HT off. This is emergency operate push button. And this is the switch when we require to change the polarity of the impulse. We have to change the polarity here, as well as we have to change the polarity of the diode. And this is for providing the trigger to the bottom electrode, that is trigotron sphere gap. This is digital storage oscilloscope of 60 megahertz to record the impulse voltage waveform. Okay. Now this is mains on. Now this indicates that distance between the spheres is 7.58 mm. Now here I will open the ground rod. So it has opened. Now we can apply the voltage. Now here I will show that the distance between the spheres is increasing. This is increasing, so you can see here it will increase. Now decrease, it is decreasing. Now I will demonstrate the same thing at the impulse generator.
Now I am opening the ground. Now I am closing it. Again opening it. Now I am increasing the distance between this spark gap. Now I am increasing the distance between this spark gap.
Now I will show how the trigger is generated at the rod electrode, that is at the first pair of the spark gap electrode, by means of this trigger. Now, I will show how the impulse voltage is generated. Now, this is digital storage oscilloscope. The voltage is adjusted to 20 volts per division and time scale is 10 microseconds per division. Now, this 20 volts correspond to 20 kV in the impulse generator because the resistance divider ratio is 1000:1. Now, mains on. I will open this switch, ground switch.
distance between the spheres I have adjusted to 10.2 mm. Now HT on. Now I am increasing the voltage. This is input voltage to the transformer, state charging resistor, state charging voltage. Now this I adjusted to 20 kV. We'll wait for about 30 seconds so that all the capacitors are charged. Applying the trigger to the lower sphere. See, only the lower sphere has triggered, but remaining spheres have not triggered. It means either we have to reduce the distance between the electrodes or we have to increase the charging voltage. So I am reducing the distance between the spheres. Now the distance is 8.5 mm. See, all the triggers, all the spheres have triggered. See, all the spheres have triggered. Now you can see the impulse voltage waveform in this DSO. This is the impulse voltage waveform. We will measure the output voltage. One division is 20 volts, so 20, 40, 60. It is 64 kV. I'm sorry, 68 kV is the impulse voltage output. Now you can see the time. To reduce to 50% of peak value, time scale is 10 microseconds per second. So 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. The waveform has reduced to 50% of the peak value. Now, in order to measure the rise time, I will change the time scale. Now it is 2.5 microseconds per division. So approximately the rise time is 2 microseconds. So in place of 1.2 microseconds, we are getting rise time of 2 microseconds. The tolerance permitted in the rise time is plus minus 30%. And we observed that tail time is 50 microseconds. And output voltage is 68 kV. 68 volts, ratio is 1000 is to 1. So it is 68 kV.
So now I have shown you how the impulse voltage waveform of positive polarity is generated. Next, I will show how the impulse voltage waveform of negative polarity is generated. Now, after performing the experiment, we have to discharge all the high voltage points. Output of the rectifier, then the spheres and so on. So now I have discharged all the high voltage terminals.
Now this diode was connected in positive polarity, therefore all the capacitors were charged to positive polarity. Now in order to generate the impulse of negative polarity, I will reverse this diode. Now see, I have changed the polarity. Again, charging voltage is 20 kV. Input voltage distance is 10.32. Now I will show the operation of this emergency switch. If I press it, supply is disconnected.
Now again, I have charged resistors to 20 kV. I am applying trigger to the lower sphere. See, the trigger is generated in the lower sphere only. Therefore, the distance either we have to reduce or we have to increase the voltage. So, I am reducing the distance.
Now I am applying the trigger. Again it is in the lower sphere only. So I will further reduce the distance. Now I am applying the trigger. I have to reduce the distance further. Now the trigger was in all the spheres. Now here you can see now
voltage waveform generated. You can see it is of negative polarity. The amplitude is approximately 70 kV. The discharge time to tell, that is T2, is 50 microseconds. I will change the time scale. You can see the rise time is approximately 2.5 microseconds. So this is how the negative polarity impulse is generated.
So friends, in this experiment, we have studied how the impulse voltage is generated and how it is measured and recorded by means of digital storage oscilloscope. Thank you.